As per the call given by the Government of India, we are all set to achieve a 5 trillion economy by 2024-25 from the current level of $2.7 trillion. When we look at the manufacturing sector, becomes very, very important for the steel industry. Of course, the demand is driven by the agriculture and also by the service sector, but major demand in the steel or metal is driven by the manufacturing sector, because it contributes close to 30% of our GDP. Again, you are all related to steel industry or metal industry. You are very well aware of how India has become the second largest producer of steel and going to be the second largest consumer of steel also in the time to come. And in this endeavor, the Government of India, Ministry of Steel particularly, has taken so many steps, and all these steps are leading to the further growth of consumption in the country. Despite the slowdown in the world, we find that in the first 6 months of the current year, the growth of the steel industry continued to be there in our country. And the steel consumption grew by close to 6%, which in itself shows, I'm not going on the prices, because prices, again, it is a function of the demand and supply, and also that from what all sources you have been getting. But the fact remains that we have grown 6% in the first 6 months of the current financial year. And I find that in the coming time also, this growth will continue. Now the issue comes that how to increase the steel intensity in the key sectors. And I always believe that this issue to be countered from the two sides. If we have to go for the sustainable demand or sustainable consumption in the country, we have to address the supply side and also the demand side. If I look from the point of view of the demand side, I find that there are four very, very important sectors of the economy where the metal or steel is required. Of course, I will come to this rural sector slightly later. But if we look at this infrastructure and construction, that constitute around 65% of the total steel consumption in the country. When we talk of metal sector, we find that the 95% consumption is that of steel only, and other metals contribute just 5%. Maybe they are precious metal, and they contribute just 5% of the total consumption. 95% is contributed by steel. And if we talk of steel holistically, then I think we are talking of the entire metal sector. So in this also, the Government of India, as you know, they have taken various steps, various schemes have been launched. Again, I need not have to talk about them. And I believe in the coming time, they are going to take more momentum, whether it is our Jal Jeevan Mission or National Gas Grid, or it is the urban housing or rural housing. They are going to take a momentum in the time to come, and they will definitely lead to the higher demand in the steel. But having said that, we still find that in our country, the cement to steel ratio is just 0.30. Steel is consumed only to the extent of 300 kg if we compare with the cement. And this ratio has to go to the international level of 1:1. And this is one reason that in India, the steel consumption is so low and the cement consumption is high. Though, if we look at holistically, that what help we get from the steel construction, and you all know that it has many advantages over the conventional structure, conventional construction, particularly in terms of environment and also in time, in terms of construction period. But of course, the cost is slightly higher. But if we look at from the life cycle point of view, we find that the cost comes down even lower than what we spend on the conventional the steel and cement construction. In this area, like in construction and infrastructure, I have identified four things which, if we are able to do, I think those will help in increasing the consumption of steel. With the great efforts of our Ministry of Steel, we have been able to get the analysis done on the basis of this life cycle cost analysis. But currently, it is not mandatory. So the word used is may, and the ministry has been trying that it should be substituted with shall. So this will help to get the infrastructure projects with a provision to choose steel intensive option also. Currently, it is the option available with the respective decision maker. And secondly, this issue I highlighted at other places also, the BIS code for general construction in steel, IS 800, it needs to be revised to include high-grade steel for building construction, like seismic resistance, weather resistance, and fire resistance structural steel, which the major steel mills manufacturing structural steel are capable of supplying today. Earlier, these steels were not available in the country, but we have gone a big way in producing the structural steel. It started with the JSPL, SAIL had also been manufacturing that, and today SAIL in itself has a capacity of around 2 million ton of giving the universal sections, which were earlier not being manufactured in the country. So these universal sections have their own advantages. They speed up the construction. And I have seen myself, like some 3 years back, I was staying in one of the hotels in Japan that was on 36th story. And just next to that, a building was coming up. I could see that building coming up at the rate of one floor every day. And they were using only structures. And as you know, Japan is the one country which has made full use of steel construction, that how to speed up the construction work by using the steel. Wherever you go, you find that the bridges are made of steel, or whatever you can think of, it is made of steel and glass only. And third is inclusion of steel structural construction and finishing items rates in the CPWD schedule of rates. Today, it is not there. Of course, it has been taken up. And fourthly, that the steel structural design expertise is not there today, and it has to be included in the curriculum of the civil engineering course in our country. And second important sector which consumes steel is the engineering and packaging segment. So here, if the infrastructure improves, naturally we will be requiring more equipment, and we talk of equipment, it will come from the engineering segment. And here also, there is a lot of scope available with the emphasis of the Government of India on the Make in India and also DMIPS policy in place. We find that all steps are being taken to encourage the use of the Indian-made steel in the country. And third sector is the automobile. And friends, as you all know, the India has already become an auto hub. And most of the major players, they have set up their facilities in the country. Many of them have started with the assembly only, but in the due course, they will also come up with the manufacturing within the country. And this is also going to help us. And with the income levels and this young demographics going up, and in passenger and commercial vehicle segment, this demand is also growing to go up. And fourth important sector, which we never counted as would be consuming that much of steel, is the defense sector. And defense sector is coming up like anything, and with the entry of the private sector in the defense manufacturing, the steel consumption is going to get a boost. And you know that the one submarine requires 5,000 to 10,000 tons of steel plate, depending on the size of the submarine. And these plates, we have already started manufacturing in the country. And the one aircraft carriers requires 40,000 ton to 60,000 ton of steel plates, again, depending on the size. And each lightweight armored vehicle requires 8 ton of steel, and every tank requires 20 ton of steel. I'm sure. So as we go in for more defense spending, more manufacturing of defense equipment in the country, the consumption is going to go up in this area also. So, dosto, ye to ek taraf hua, ye hua hamari demand side. Lekin supply side pe bhi humko bahut hi satark rehna hoga. We have to work, I think, more on the supply side than on the demand side. I'm sure as the country is growing, and we will be able to have a GDP growth of 7 to 8%. As you know, it has a multiplier effect. The CRISIL has given, earlier it was at 1.25 times, but now they have said it is 1.15 times. So steel consumption is going to grow in the country, and we have to very holistically address the supply side. अगर हम सप्लाई साइड की तरफ देखते हैं तो सबसे बड़ी जो हमारी प्रॉब्लम आती है वो है सस्टेनेबिलिटी और एनवायरनमेंट की। हम आज भी 1.8 टन ऑफ CO2 इमिजन होता है 1 टन ऑफ क्रूड स्टील बनाने के लिए, जो कि काफ़ी हाई है, और इसको हमको किस तरह से कम करना है, ये WSA की फिगर हैं, इसको हमको किस तरह से कम करना है ये हमको देखना पड़ेगा। और आज जो स्टील इंडस्ट्री है दैट इज़ रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर 7 to 9% ऑफ द ग्लोबल CO2 इमिजन बाई यूज ऑफ द फॉसिल फ्यूल। So this has to be reduced. Likewise, the water consumption, as you know, water is not going to be there for all the time to come. So water consumption has to be reduced in the industry. Today, though, it is just 3.3 meter cube per ton of crude steel. I'm talking of net consumption of water, which gets evaporated in the atmosphere. How this can be reduced? Because water is not going to stay here for all the time to come. So this is going to be one very important thing. And whatever technologies are required, that we have to develop with the help of research and development. Speakers before me, they have also talked of research and development, that in our country, the expenditure on research and development is the lowest today. And that's why even for certain basic type of steels, we have to look for technology from abroad. Like, we have been manufacturing steel for the last 60 years, but so far we have not been able to manufacture CRGO steel in the country. And even for making auto-grade steel, we have to look for technology from outside. Of course, many works have been going on, but they have not culminated into final product so far. Most important thing which I always talk of is the cost. How to bring down the cost of production in our country? If we have to be globally competitive, we have to bring down the cost of production. Like I have been told by some of the Chinese CEO that their cost of production is close to $350 per ton. At times, I do not believe it that any country can produce steel at such a low rate. And for that, it is very important that we reduce the consumption of our inputs and we bring improvement in our techno-economic parameters, whether it is in the integrated steel sector or it is in the, say, secondary steel sector. Quality and techno-economic parameters, consumption, they are going to play a key role in reducing the cost of production. Now, industry has to see that how we can bring down the cost of production by adopting the, say, better techno-economic parameters and also by substituting some of the materials and also by improving the consumption levels. As we know, our coal consumption is the highest, and we have been importing coal, and that constitutes the one major single factor for the cost of production. So there we have to concentrate and we have to see how we can do it so that we can provide the cheaper steel. Because whatever steel will be manufactured in the country, in addition to getting consumed in the country, it has to be exported also. And for that, we need to be very, very cost effective. So I find that if we are able to take care of these two aspects, that is the supply side and also the demand side, nobody can stop us in this our endeavor of steeling India, where we can increase the intensity of steel in all the sectors of the economy. Friends, now let us talk of rural sector. Without rural sector, we cannot progress in consumption of steel. जैसा कि एक बार कहा गया था कि जो भारत जो है गांव में बसता है, तो गांव को छोड़कर हम स्टील की परिकल्पना नहीं कर सकते। लेकिन आज दुर्भाग्य है कि हमारा जो रूरल सेक्टर में कंजम्पशन है वो अभी भी 90 kg पर है पर कैपिटा। इसलिए मैं समझता हूं कि इस एरिया में एक बहुत बड़ा स्कोप है जहां कि हम स्टील का कंजम्पशन इसमें बढ़ा सकते हैं। और बहुत सारे ऐसे एरियाज हैं जैसे कि रूरल हाउसिंग है, आंगनवाड़ीज है, बायो टॉयलेट्स हैं, कम्युनिटी सेंटर्स हैं, कैटल शेड्स वगैरह हैं, इसको हम बढ़ावा देकर स्टील कंजम्पशन को बढ़ा सकते हैं। और ऐसे ही ग्रेन स्टोरेज के लिए जो साइलोस हैं उनका निर्माण हम करके और उनको हम बढ़ावा देके इसको हम स्टील के कंजम्पशन को हम उसमें बढ़ा सकते हैं। और ऐसे ही है जैसे एग्री इक्विपमेंट, जैसे हमारा एग्रीकल्चर बढ़ेगा, एग्री इक्विपमेंट की जरूरत होगी, मशीनरीज की जरूरत होगी, कोल्ड स्टोरेज की जरूरत होगी, तो उन सब के लिए भी स्टील का कंजम्पशन होगा ही होगा। एंड जैसे जैसे हमारी जो इनकम है फार्मर्स की वो बढ़ेगी, आपको मालूम होगा कि हमने एक प्रण लिया है कि हम जो फार्मर्स की इनकम है 2022 तक डबल करेंगे। अगर हम इनकम डबल करेंगे तो डिस्पोजेबल इनकम बढ़ेगी और उसके साथ साथ उनकी स्पेंडिंग भी बढ़ेगी, जो कि हमको मदद करेगी स्टील का कंजम्पशन बढ़ाने के लिए। इसको देखते हुए सेल ने एक मुहिम शुरू किया है जिसको कि हम बोलते हैं सेल स्टील गांव की ओर। तो हमने काफ़ी सारे इसमें वर्कशॉप्स और काफ़ी सारे हमने कार्यशालाएं आयोजित किए हैं, जिसमें कि हम अपने जो स्टेक होल्डर्स हैं, मेनली जो पंचायत के हेड्स हैं और जो विलेज लेवल के डिसीजन मेकर्स हैं, ओपिनियन मेकर्स हैं, मेसन्स हैं, बिल्डर्स हैं, उनको हम अपने साथ लेकर चल रहे हैं और उनको बता रहे हैं कि किस तरह से हम स्टील यूज़ करके खर्चा नहीं बढ़ा रहे, बल्कि हम एक लॉन्ग टर्म बेसिस पे देखें तो हम खर्चे को कम कर रहे हैं। इसके साथ साथ सेल ने जो अपना एक इनिशिएटिव लिया है, हमने अपना जो TMT है उसकी ब्रांडिंग किया है, जिसको कि हम सिक्योर के नाम से जानते हैं। इसको हम SEQR सिक्योर सेल सिक्योर के नाम से जानते हैं, जो कि ऑलरेडी हमने अपना ईस्टर्न इंडिया में काफ़ी जोर शोर से लॉन्च किया और काफ़ी हमारा इसको गांव में स्टील बेचने में हमें मदद मिली है इसके लिए। और ये 500D स्टील है जो कि सब मैन्युफैक्चरर बनाते हैं। और इसके साथ साथ हमने जो स्ट्रक्चरल्स को अपना नया ब्रांड नेम दिया है वो है नेक्स्ट, जिसकी हम मार्केटिंग कर रहे हैं और आने वाले समय में मुझे लगता है दिस इज़ गोइंग टू बी द फ्यूचर ऑफ स्टील। रूरल एरिया में स्टील को हमको बढ़ाना ही होगा। द टुडे LTIFR लॉस्ट टाइम इंजरी फ्रीक्वेंसी रेट इन द स्टील इंडस्ट्री इज द हाईएस्ट, एज पर WSA इट इज 0.88 विच इज द हाईएस्ट इन एनी इंडस्ट्री। सो दिस हैज़ टू बी ब्रॉट डाउन टू ए लेवल ऑफ समवेयर अराउंड 0.11 और 0.15, and that will happen only when we bring the safety in the culture of the people, otherwise these accidents will keep on happening. And not only in say public sector this problem is there in all the sectors, all the whether it is private sector steel manufacturing also this issue is there. Safety is a big concern for all of us.